everyone, and welcome to At Home with the Bay. My name is Cindy Willems, and I'm the Director of Education for the Galveston Bay Foundation. We are so excited to bring you this series of virtual field trips. Each video will include virtual labs and field trip activities, a conservation craft, talks with bay biologists, and an outside activity that you can safely participate with. Today's topic is Galveston Bay oysters and oyster reefs. Do you think you can outfilter an oyster?
Hi, my name's Megan, and we are going to do an oyster dissection. We will talk about what is on the inside of an oyster. Have you ever thought about what's in this? Is it just a rock? Does it have eyes? Does it have a stomach? Well, let's open it up and find out. First, before we start the dissection, we need to go over safety.
If you would like to do this on your own, make sure you have safety glasses, gloves in case of shellfish allergies, a shucker, and an adult to help you with this. It's very sharp, and some tweezers.
You want to slide your shucker through the top.
Once you hear the pop, that means that you have unhooked the hinge or the umbo of the oyster. Before you try to take off the top of the oyster, you want to slide your shucker towards the back, all the way up to scrape off the rest of the shell.
Now, you can see the inside. Let's take a closer look.
An oyster is a type of shellfish called a bivalve. Bivalve means two shells. The shells keep the soft body of the oyster safe. Oysters hold their shell together by an abductor muscle. This muscle allows the oyster to open and close its shell. Oysters open their shell to siphon in nutrients and algae to eat. They close their shell to protect them against predators.
First, it looks just like a blob, but when you look closer, you'll notice this is a very complex organism. They have a mantle covering their body, and on the outskirts of the mantle, you'll see cilia outlining it. Cilia is what brings the food and particles around to the oyster's mouth. So let's go ahead and pick up the mantle. Now that the mantle is up, you can see the gills. This is how the oyster breathes. They have four gills. One, two, three, four. If you look further, right here is the palp. This sorts what the oyster wants to put into its mouth. Its mouth is right up here. We have the stomach. You'll see this brown section here. After the food goes through the palp, in the mouth, up the stomach, and then you can guess where the rest goes, out through the rectum. It is hidden under the mantle, right here. And right below the abductor muscle is the heart. If you see that little ball, that is the oyster's heart. If it were a fresh oyster, you could still see it beating. However, it's not the case with this oyster. Did you ever think that an oyster was that complex? I know I didn't. Now you're going to join our bay biologist to learn more about what we are doing with oyster reefs. I'll see you next time.
The dominant oyster that is found in Galveston Bay is the eastern oyster. Eastern oysters are abundant in shallow saltwater bays, lagoons, and estuaries, in water 8 to 25 feet deep and between 28 and 90 degrees Fahrenheit. Growth of oysters in Texas waters is relatively fast and occurs throughout the year. Under ideal conditions, baby oysters, also known as spat, may grow up to be 3 inches in 15 months. These oysters will grow on top of one another to form reefs. Since oysters specifically need to live on other oyster shells, Galveston Bay Foundation's oyster shell recycling program is an important piece of reef restoration. It focuses on increasing the population of eastern oysters by returning shucked oyster shells collected from local restaurants back to Galveston Bay to create new oyster habitat and a healthier bay for all. Many volunteers come out with us to bag the oyster shell and help create new reefs. To date, we have recycled over 1,000 tons of oyster shells. Oyster reefs have many important jobs in Galveston Bay. Reefs are shelter and feeding grounds for a variety of animals throughout the food chain, including flounder, spotted trout, stingrays, blue crabs, grass shrimp, mussels, and barnacles. The diversity and abundance of species living in the reef area depends on the health of the reef. Not only do healthier reefs contain more oysters, but they also contain more fish and crabs. Oyster reefs also stabilize the sandy bay bottom and break wave energy, helping to reduce erosion on the shoreline. And oyster reefs are good for the economy. Many people like to eat oysters. In an average year, the Galveston Bay oyster fishery contributes approximately $9 million to the Texas economy. Now, let's visit Shannon with our oyster recycling team at one of our curing sites to learn more.
Hi, this is Shannon, and I'm out here at our curing site. All of this shell here has been collected by the Galveston Bay Foundation. The shell has been collected from the restaurants that we partner with, and the shell will sit out here in the sun for at least 6 months to get rid of all the bacteria off the shell. The shell will then be taken back to Galveston Bay to create new oyster habitat. If you eat oysters, please be sure to eat them at the restaurants that we partner with. Those are Tommy's Restaurant and Oyster Bar, Tookie Seafood, Crazy Allen Swamp Shack and Kima and Baybrook, the Aquarium at the Kima Boardwalk, Captain Benny's off the Gulf Freeway, Sam's Boat in Seabrook, and Boulevard Seafood. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Mariah, and today we're going to be doing a filtration activity to see if we can outfilter an oyster. Did you know that a single oyster can filter up to 50 gallons of water in one day? While oysters filter water, they are also removing pollutants such as trash, fertilizers, and various types of chemicals. This is really important because the oysters are helping to support the health of Galveston Bay.
For this activity, you'll need scissors, a water bottle that's been cut in half, and various types of mediums, such as paper towels, napkins, gauze pads, and coffee filters. You'll also need a rubber band and dirty water that you can create with just regular tap water and dirt from your backyard.
So more than likely, you might have some of these items laying around your house. So let's get started with the activity. First thing you want to do is take your cut in half water bottle and take the top part and place it into the bottom half to where it's creating a funnel. And then you want to choose two mediums. So we're going to choose our coffee filter. Place it into the water bottle. And we will choose a paper towel as the second medium. There's no wrong way to assemble your filter. You can do it any kind of way you want, just as long as you secure it with a rubber band. So I'm going to create a second filter, and we're going to see which one of these designs filters water the best. So for this one, I chose gauze. We'll put that on the bottom of the funnel, secure it with a rubber band, and on the inside, I'll place a napkin. All right, so these are the two designs. One of them has a napkin and gauze. The second one has the coffee filter and paper towel.
You can see that the design to the left didn't filter as well as the design to the right did. This one is more clean and clear, and this one has some dirt that escaped through the bottom of the funnel. Now that we saw how well these two homemade filters cleaned water, imagine them competing against live oysters in the bay.
So this is a really easy activity that you can do at home. So try it out and see if you can outfilter an oyster.
Outside to enjoy the bay is kayaking. But safety first, always wear a life jacket and always kayak with an adult. A few reasons I like kayaking is because I just like going on the water and floating. A few animals I love to see while I'm kayaking are ducks, sometimes fish, and turtles. While you're kayaking, make sure to take a photo and tag Galveston Bay Foundation. Bye!
How awesome was that?
We learned about parts of an oyster with Megan.
And we heard why oyster reefs are so important and what the Galveston Bay Foundation is doing to restore our oyster reefs in the bay. We also tried to outfilter an oyster with Mariah.
And saw a great way to get outside and enjoy the bay.
Stay tuned with the Galveston Bay Foundation. We have more great things coming up.
See you next week.